Hi, I'm Tom Griffin. Welcome to the last installment of the Owning a Grinder series. We're going to talk about glazed diamonds and how to make sure that that doesn't happen to you, and then how to troubleshoot when it does. Glazed diamonds. One of the biggest challenges you're going to run into on the job site, aside from power and, you know, getting machines on and off, is what happens when you glaze your diamonds. So productivity is gonna drop dramatically because your diamonds literally stop working. But what causes that? So typically what we find is that you're running diamonds too fast with too much weight. So you're getting too much heat and friction. And what that causes is for the metal matrix that bonds all the diamonds together to melt and literally glaze and coat the diamonds. So now you basically just have diamonds that are spinning on top of the concrete. So what are some ways you might notice that you've glazed your diamonds? So when you're doing a job and your diamonds are brand new, you're gonna see that they're really productive. It's generating a lot of dust. You're really cutting in and breaking the surface tension of the concrete. If you're glazing your diamonds, you're gonna notice that over time, you're making a lot less dust. Your diamonds aren't breaking that surface tension. You're really having to go a lot slower over areas or making multiple passes. So all of those decreases in productivity is a really good indicator that you've probably glazed your diamonds. So that doesn't mean that your diamonds are done for. There are ways to unglaze them. I'm gonna talk about one of them, or two of them that I like that are pretty similar. There's some others that out there that involve blow torches and a bunch of other stuff. I'm not gonna deal with that today. Something that I really like is if you're at a job site, always have like a bag of play sand. You know, it's 100% silica. You know, if you glaze your diamonds, find a patch, put some silica, some sand down, disconnect your dust collector, make sure you're safe, get it a little bit wet, and then run your diamonds through that silica. And what that silica is gonna do is, because it's so rough and so abrasive, it's gonna break that glazed part of the diamond and it's gonna open up those diamonds again and allow you to be productive. If you don't have that and you're on a job site, one way that you can do it, if you notice you're starting to glaze your diamonds, is to move from an area that you're already prepping into an area that's not prepped and back. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna be kind of similar. It's that rougher area that you've already prepped is gonna help to roughen up and break that surface tension on the actual diamond itself and help to unglaze it. And one third way that you can do it, and I don't recommend it because you're probably gonna end up with somebody mad at you, is if you're at a job site with an asphalt parking lot, you can take your diamonds out to the parking lot and run them on the asphalt, and that's gonna unglaze them in no time, but it's definitely gonna mess up the parking lot. So you've got a few different options there to unglaze your diamonds, but don't think that you're done for when it does happen. It happens to everybody. You just have to be able to manage it, and you know, once you can fix it, then you're back up and going.